بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله بارئ الخلائق أجمعين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وخاتم النبيين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المذلومين الغر الميامين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا
اللهم صل على محمد
ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات على محمد وآل محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
Respected brothers and sisters, if you can recall and remember, these kuffar and mushrikeen, in earlier verses, Quran speaks about them, that they showed their arrogance and rudeness toward Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they were told that make sajda to Rahman, they said, who is Rahman? We don't know Rahman. Are you commanding us to make sajda to someone we don't know? They knew very well, but they spoke with arrogance and contempt toward Rabbul Alameen, someone who is Rahman, someone whose mercy is inclusive. But they say, Mar Rahman, who is Rahman? And then Quran, in the verses followed by that verse, spoke about who is Rahman. In following verses which we spoke about and explained to you, define who is Rahman. This whole world is expression of His Rahman, Ar-Rahmaniyya. That's the introduction of Rahman. Whoever you are, whatever you are enjoying, the breath you take in, you are breathing, it is rahmat of that Rahman. This day and night is rahmat of Rahman. This whole universe, rahmat of Rahman. Sun and moon, rahmat of Rahman. And all of them moving in a particular, you know, circle and orbit, burujan, rahmat of Rahman. Huh? All that is rahmat of Rahman. But this spreaded mercy of Rahman is only source of guidance for those who want to be thankful. Shakura, who want to be thankful, who want to be, you know, people who want to remember or reflect, yadakkar or arada shukura. Who are those who want to be thankful? After explaining who is Rahman, now from verse number 63 onward till end of Surah Mubarakah Furqan, Quran speaks about qualities of Ibadur Rahman, servants of Rahman, Ibadur Rahman. What a beautiful title, really. What a beautiful medal. More than that, not possible to define then ourselves, who we are, Ibadur Rahman. We are servants of Rahman, Ibadur Rahman. What are their qualities? In these verses, at least 12 qualities Quran discusses. And inshallah, our focus will be on these qualities. From here onward, we will go very slow, inshallah, almost till end of Ramadan, inshallah. So we understand a little bit deeply what are the striking qualities of servants of the merciful Ibadur Rahman. Verse number 63 says, let me translate for you after giving you this background. Wa ibadur rahman alladhina yamshuna alal arzi hawn. The servants of the most merciful are those who walk upon the earth in humility. Humbleness. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Allahu Akbar. And when ignorant, jahil, ignorant, addresses them, try to speak to them, debate with them, they don't debate. What they say? قَالُوا Salam, they say peace. They say peace. وَالَّذِينَ يَبْوِتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. They are the one who pass the night prostrating themselves to their Lord and standing up. Their night is spent either in sajda or in qiyam. وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ They are the one who say, رَبَّنَ صْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا. They are the one who humbly ask from their Lord and say toward their Rabb, رَبَّنَا Our Lord, صْرِفْ عَنَّا Divert from us azab and punishment of Jahannam, because that punishment and suffering is a constant one, is a continuous one, is a ever adhering one. Allahu Akbar. Inna sa'at mustaqarran wa maqama. It is indeed a miserable residence and destination. Allahu Akbar. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Yes, brothers and sisters. As I mentioned to you, from here onward, 12 attributes of Ibadur Rahman. The first attribute of Ibadur Rahman, Quran speaks and expresses like that. Alladhina yamshuna alal arzi hawna. This is the number one. That when they walk on the earth, they walk on the earth with humility, with humbleness. Easy. And there comes the first quality of Abdur Rahman and Ibadur Rahman, humility, modesty, down to earth. How I must explain? In Arabic it is called tawazo. And tawadu comes from wada. And wada means to place something. Tawadu means that when you place yourself lower than other people, not above other people. That is called tawadu. Now, tawadu or humility is a spirit of ibadat, ubudiyyah in fact, ibadur rahman. Who are defined in these verses? Ibadur rahman, those who are servants of Rahman. Now if someone is servant, please listen carefully, very important points. If someone is servant, what is the first consequences of being servant? That servant must be humble. Servant must be down to earth. Servant must be, you know, I don't know more words in English, but must be, you know, that may be negative, inshallah, we'll speak. Therefore, I avoided that submissiveness. No, tawazu is not submissiveness. Humility, maybe that is the word properly. Now, so ruh of ubudiyat is humble. If you are servant of Rahman, then you must be humble. And humbleness or humility has different phases, which I would like tonight to explain to you quickly. This is a very detailed discussion. This issue of tawazu, honestly, my brothers, I will not go in that detail, but probably 3-4 nights we can continuously speak about it. Ruh, Imam, you know, someone, let me tell you something now before I go. Someone came to Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wassalam and asked this question, Yabna Rasulullah, we see when you make ibadat, you enjoy. Why we don't enjoy any ibadat? We want to get it done as soon as possible. Why we don't have that joy in making ibadat? Why we don't taste that, exact wording was, sweetness, halal in ibadat? Why? What is the sweetness of ibadat we are missing, Yabna Rasulullah? Imam Sadiq replied, sweetness of ibadat comes from tawazu, from humility. Because you are lacking humility, therefore you don't enjoy ibadat. You don't taste sweetness of ibadat. Salawat ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
Now, as I said, humility or tawazu has phases. Phase number one, humility before Allah. First humility is being humble toward Allah Almighty, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Humility before Allah. And what is the source of this humility? Please listen carefully. This is a lot of discussion, but I'm just trying to make it as short as possible. That humility before Allah comes from Ma'rifatullah. and ma'rifatun nafs. Man arifa nafsa faqad arifa rabbah. If you know yourself, you know your Allah. If you know who you are, you will be able to know who is your Lord. And if you know who you are, and if you know who is your Lord, automatically, you know, you will have humility, humbleness, tawadhu. Why? Because if you recognize yourself, who you are, you realize that you are really nothing. You are nothing, nothing. And from realization of nothingness in yourself, you transfer to the greatness of Allah. Who I am and who is my Lord. And as your ma'rifat increases, listen please carefully, as your ma'rifat increases, your humility also increases. And as much as your jahl increases, opposite to humility, which is arrogance, takabbur, and istikbar, that increases. Are you with me or not? This example I have given, I don't know how many times, but it's a beautiful example to give it. You know, arrogance is a result of jahl, and tawazu is a result of ilm. Real ilm, huh? Not the fake ilm. Huh? Otherwise, fake ilm makes you very arrogant. Allahu Akbar. Those fake ulama, they think they are God. They fake ulama treat other people like animals. Worse than that. But those who are ulama rabbaniyin, as hadith says, alimun rabbani. The most genuine ulama, no. As their ilm increases, their humility increases. They say, I have given an example before, but it's a very interesting example, very nice, simple example for those who are new, maybe also to listen to this example. What is that example? That there was a student in Qom who just recently joined, you know, University of Qom to learn Deen, Islam and so on. First few days, he learned those few books, you know, Zaraba, Zaraba, Zarabu, those, you know, basic, very basic things, you know. One day he was sitting in the masjid and he was measuring his chest like that. How big is my chest? So a big alim came close by him. He said, brother, my son, what's wrong with you? Why are you measuring your chest? He was trying to measure his chest. How big is his chest? He said, Sheikh, I'm a little bit stuck. He said, where you are stuck? He said, I don't know. I'm thinking so much of ilm in such a small chest. How it has captured? And same student, if he really travels the path of Marifat of Haq, reaches to the point where becomes Marja Mushtahid Imam Khomeini Rahmatullahi Alayhi, reaches to that level of Imam, Taqwa and Marifat, but what he says, I don't know anything. I have wasted my life. Allahu Akbar. I am no one but a small student. It's not, don't think it's just a protocol. It's not a protocol, it's reality. As much as your ma'rifat increases about Allah, you realize that how little you know. It's not a protocol. Don't think it's just a, you know, show off type of thing. No. Genuinely he's saying, I know nothing, I know very little. Because he realizes he's exposed to that ocean of knowledge. And when now he compares to what he got, to that ocean of ma'rifat, he says, I don't have even a drop of this ocean. And therefore it brings him more humble and humble and humble. Very, very important. Brother and sister, salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Yes. And then, Allahu Akbar. Very, very important is this issue of tawazu indallah. Tawazu indallah is one phase or one level of tawazu, which is the highest level of tawazu. The second phase of tawazu and humility is to be humble before people. To be humble before Allah is one thing, and I explained to you. And to be humble before creation of Allah is second phase of tawazu. Now what is the background of that tawazu? Again, the background of that tawazu and humbleness and humility is ma'rifat. Ma'rifat again. Real ma'rifat. When you look at other people, Imam explains, you think who I am, who these people who are around me. They are either, there are three possibilities. They are either worse than me, lower than me, or they are better than me, or they are equal to me. Worse than me, very difficult to believe. Why? Because you know your own secrets, you don't know their secrets. What is the possibility? Maybe better, why? Because maybe they got something which you don't have. Maybe equal. But what is the guarantee of being equal? No guarantee. Because you don't know the other person. Now, as much as ma'rifat of nafs means what? As much as you think about yourself and you realize that how many weaknesses you have, how many shortcomings you have, how many mistakes you have made in life, how much, you know, shaky parts are there in your personality, as much as you realize, you think that maybe I got this problem, this man opposite me does not have that problem. Does not have that problem. Allahu Akbar. And therefore, with this approach and ma'rifat, when you look at other people, you say, of course he is better than me and I am less than him. And you humble down before that person. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
One day, let me just give you an example. One day, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam saw people are gathered around somebody and they are making a lot of noises, you know, people got together somewhere and somebody is there. Prophet tried to see what's happening, why all people are around in this corner. This or there's a mad guy, somebody mentally, unfortunately, not balanced, and he is doing funny things. And people are making fun of him, laughing, enjoying, because he's doing funny things, mad, mental. Prophet looked at this scene very calmly, Hadith says, and then turned back and tried to to address the people. He said, people listen, can I speak to you? He said, do you want me to introduce to you someone who is real mad, someone who is genuinely crazy, mad? They all got quiet. Shut up. Laughing, making noise. They kept quiet. So, okay, Bismillah, go ahead. Prophet replied like that. I got this hadith in front of me now. Al-mubtakhar fi mashyihi, an-nazir fi itfai, al-muharrik jambay bimankabay, الذي لا يؤمن شره ولا يرجى خيره فذلك المجنون وهذا المبتلى. الله اكبر الله اكبر. What a great wording by Prophet. He said, genuinely crazy and mad is someone who walks on the earth like he owns the earth. Al-Mubtahar, like that. An-Nazir. And he looks this way, that way, like that. Al-Mutaharriku jambay bimankabay. And then he moves two of the shoulders like that. Like that. Alladhi la yu'min shar. His shar is not protected. His shar reaches to everybody. And nothing good reaches from him to no one. Prophet says, this arrogant and rude character, فَرْضَوْلِكَ الْمَجْنُونَ, he is mad. This poor guy, you making fun of him, فَهَازَ الْمُبْتَلَى, he is only sick, my brother. He is not feeling well. Allahu Akbar. But real mad is that, that thinks of himself something, while he is nothing. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Allah.
Yes, brothers and sisters, this is second phase of tawazu. Tawazu in front of the people. Tawazu in front of the people. Third level of tawazu and humility is, which we understand from this verse. I didn't get a chance, I thought I will do it in the last. This verse, Ibadur Rahman, الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا, is not directly saying that they are humble. It's saying when they walk on the earth, they walk with humility, slowly, respectfully. Now, this verse indirectly saying that their attitude, now please listen carefully, their attitude shows what is their inside. That's the point which I was supposed to explain before getting into detailed discussion. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala
Muhammad.
Quran is saying that from the way Ibadur Rahman walk, you understand that they are inside their heart humble. In other words, this quality of humility is expressed in their attitude. A lot of people think maybe they in their own their mind, maybe they humble, but they don't think that they are someone, they are too big, they are great, they are someone, or they look at other people with contempt. No, maybe they are very nice, they think about other people also good, they don't think they are very big. But the way they walk, the way they talk, the way they act is not expression of that humility. Problem, Quran says no. Ibadur Rahman express their humility in their character, in their attitude, in their behavior. See, the word yamshun means walking, but yamshun comes from mashi. And mashi has another meaning also. Mashi does not only mean walking. Mashi means lifestyle. You understand what I'm trying to say? Are you with me? They walk on the earth humbly, with humility. Another deeper meaning is that their lifestyle is humble lifestyle. They are not arrogant. The opposite point is arrogance. Abbas takbar, the worst disease for ibadat and ubudiyat is istikbar, is arrogance, is takabbur. So mashi is expression of that inner quality which comes, as I just now explained to you, from Arafat. And Arafat are gone, Ahle Irfan and Ahle Ma'na are gone in great details to explain that how this humility and humbleness, you know, developed in the person. They go in the great detail that there are some people, by nature they are humble, bizarre they are humble and mutawadi. And there are people, they're not like that. But as their marifat grows, and as this realization of who is their Lord and who they are increases, this humility comes in them. But in both cases, this humility appears, manifests in their attitude. Their lifestyle is a humble lifestyle. That's important. Are you with me or not? Humility, 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 tawazu, tawazu, tawazu. The third level of humility, which we understand from the same words, that they are humble toward Allah. They are humble toward people and society. Yamshuna alal arzihuna. And if you put this verse with other verses, remember in Surah Mubarakah Luqman, years back, we did tafsir of Surah Luqman. One of the advices Luqman gave to his son was what? What was that? Lan tahrak wajhi. Walan takhlubul arza. I'm sorry, salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
Where? Luqman says to the son, don't make your face that you are someone. Don't walk on the earth, then you will be able to, lan takhlubul arza, that you will take over the whole earth. And earth is under your control. Now, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرْحًا. Ahsan, shukran. وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ. Don't walk on the earth with arrogance. Don't walk. Walk with humbleness. Now, another very important point where we understand here is tawazu toward environment. Muhit. Toward earth. Nowadays we talk about green and right of environment and how we use the natural resources and so on and so on. Yamshuna alal arzihuna means that they are toward environment, toward natural resources, their approach is a humble approach. They look at these Ne'mats of Allah, favors of Allah, blessings of Allah, they treat them with respect. They don't just ruin them. They just don't just take over them. No. Walking on the earth or upon the earth with humble means, they are humble before nature. Another humility level of humility. Brothers, it's 9 o'clock. It's still a couple of discussions around tawazu, you know, is there. I need to complete, and as I said, these discussions will take a little bit time. We have, alhamdulillah, another 2 weeks to go. So, little bit more discussion around this. I would like to continue, inshallah, tomorrow. And the point which in the start we mentioned, very important, tomorrow night we'll discuss. Humility, humbleness is something, quality of Abadur Rahman, positive quality, value. But humility is not humiliation. Humility is not submissiveness. Humility is not to drop down. That is another discussion. You see, that is very important point. We said humble and arrogance. Humility versus arrogance. But there are certain places where you will not believe. Islam tells us that humility is not good. Arrogance is good. You cannot be humble everywhere. Where? Inshallah. That discussion tomorrow night. We will continue. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa ahli baytihi at-tahirin salawat.